Chris Hall, South Dakota Game Fish and Parks. It's October. For most people, it means blaze orange and pheasant hunting season. But I'm here today on the shores of Lake Oahe at the Whitlock Bay Salmon Spawning Station. We've got a fall run of Chinook salmon looking for a place to spawn, and we've got a group of South Dakota Game Fish and Parks biologists ready to help them.
Yeah, the whole process here is we're spawning fall Chinook salmon. This is a callback facility, meaning that the adults return in the fall, come back up the fish ladder to us, and we collect the eggs from the females, fertilize the males, and we use the males to fertilize the eggs, and to actually continue the whole process. We start the ladder about the end of September, and actually flow water down the ladder. That forms a natural attraction that salmon would come back to. They come back up the fish ladder, and that's when we can collect the adults to spawn for future spawn. The cage is actually something that allows us to crowd fish into, lift up a number of fish at the same time, move those fish over into a CO2 tank filled with water to basically put the fish into a deep sleep, kill the fish so that they're easier to work with and spawn. These are a fall run Chinook. Whether we collected them and spawned them, you know, and killed the fish and collected the eggs, these fish would die out in the wild within 1 to 2 months trying to find their own place to spawn. There's no natural reproduction of Chinook salmon in Lake Oahe. So what we'll do is we'll crowd the males up in, anesthetize them, and then actually strip the milt out of the males into a container, and then we'll bring the females in, strip the eggs out of those females into a pan, and then add the milt to those eggs, and then add water. And at the stage at which we add water, that's when the actual fertilization process occurs. And that's when, within a minute of time, those will become fertilized eggs to potentially produce small Chinook for Lake Oahe in the future. These eggs go back to one of our two cold water hatcheries. They'll either go to Cleghorn Springs Fish Hatchery in Rapid City, or McNenny State Fish Hatchery near Spearfish, South Dakota. We hold those and then we'll stock them back in to Lake Oahe either in April and May of the following spring, or hold them a little longer, get them to a larger size, and stock them in late October, November. I'd like to stock about 350,000 fish back in Lake Oahe. What that means is we need to collect about 1 million eggs to reach that goal, because what we found is about a third of the eggs we collect end up turning into fish.